Hi, my name is David Buss. I'm a professor of psychology at the University of Texas at Austin. I'm an evolutionary psychologist, and I specialize in the study of human mating strategies. How does evolutionary psychology inform the science-religion dialogue? I think it's a really interesting question. From my point of view, all we have is our evolved psychology. There's no such thing as a non-evolved psychology. So understanding religion requires understanding the underlying evolved psychological mechanisms on which religion is based. Now, some hypotheses are that there are adaptations specifically for religions, for religious belief. The dominant view is that religious belief and religions are byproducts of evolved psychological mechanisms for other things. And I'm inclined to this latter belief if I had to put my money on one horse or another. I think that there are several important evolved psychological mechanisms that play into our understanding of religion from a scientific perspective. One has to do with our coalitional psychology. Humans are intensely coalitional. And we evolved in small groups, and these groups were in conflict with other groups. And so group membership, displaying signals that you are good coalitional members was absolutely critical, and I think religion is partly involved in that, in coalitional psychology. A second thing has to do with my area of expertise, which is human mating strategies. One of the most important things that groups contain are reproductively relevant resources, and particular potential mates, as well as allies that can lead to elevated status within the group, which then gives access to mates. And so individual mating opportunities are readily abundant in groups, and so groups contain concentrations of reproductively valuable resources. And so I don't think you can divorce religion from human mating strategies. Of course, the links are more intricate, and they involve whether you are a religious leader or a religious follower, your position within the social hierarchy, within the religious group, etc. A third thing I would mention is something that I haven't seen talked about, but which I think is an important idea, and it stems from some of my work, a theory that I developed with Marty Hazelton, and that's called error management theory. And basically what error management theory says is that when there's uncertainty in your environment and you can make a mistake, there are basically two ways to go wrong. You can think that something exists when it doesn't exist, or you can fail to perceive that something exists when it in fact does exist. So the logic is when there's a cost asymmetry between these errors of inference, then selection, evolution by selection, will favor a cognitive bias to err in the direction of avoiding the more costly error. And in the case of religious belief, and this is an unexplored hypothesis, I guess, I think some people view the belief in a higher deity as possibly an error management bias, in the sense of, well, we don't know, there's great uncertainty, and so maybe it's better to be safe than sorry. And so some people might err on the side of believing rather than not believing for that purpose. So of course that genuine true belief has to be distinguished from pretending to believe as a signal to the group. So I think those three things are critical. Coalitional psychology, sexual strategies, and error management theory. Thank you.